Scusi, I have to go back to my friend now.
Signorina, perché?
Thank you very much. I really enjoyed it.
Where'd you stop?
Well, among other things, don't you think it's time to go home?
It's not that late.
Isn't it after midnight?
So what? Go ahead, he's waiting for you.
No more dancing. Awesome.
Then have some champagne.
Oh, I have some.
Ice comes with it. You dance beautifully.
You know, remember what John said. We should go back to the hotel. You need to rest.
Dee, stop treating me like an invalid, would you?
I'm not, but you have a rehearsal in the morning. You can't stay up half the night.
It's not that late.
Hey. Well, the reason for me to come on this trip was so that you would take care of yourself.
Is that a fact?
Yes. Besides, I'm exhausted.
You don't look at it exhausted. Look like you could have danced all night.
Appearances are very deceiving. Huh? Well, that's good. Plaka, may I help you?
Yes, I'd like to speak to Nikos, please.
Who's this? A friend.
Hold on a minute. I'll see if I can find him.
Thanks.
I go out the back. Yes?
Linda Spencer asked... Nikos!
I'll take care of it. You'll get cut.
I'm sorry.
No harm done. I'll get another vase.
Melinda Spencer asked me to bring those by and to tell you thank you very much.
Hello?
Nikos. It's Sheila.
Oh.
Look, I want to see you.
No. I think it's best we don't.
I know you don't want any trouble. Neither do I. I've got a whole new life here. I just want to talk to you.
Can you come here?
Sure.
All right. I have an office in the back. You don't have to go through the restaurant. You can come through the back door. You want instructions?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm looking for Nick.
Oh, he's in the office. It's in back. Go that way, turn left, second door.
Ah, thank you. Mm-hmm.
No, I don't see him anymore. Here, excuse me. Yes, come in. Oh, hi.
Oh, busy.
No. Come in, sit down. Glad to see you. Excuse me. Tomorrow night?
No, tonight. I won't stay long.
All right. Bye. Well, I wasn't expecting to see you so soon. Welcome to the Plaka.
Thank you. Gosh, it looks like a marvelous place.
You'll be my guest tonight, yes?
Thank you, Nick.
want to go in?
Oh, how much longer before curtain?
5 minutes.
Do you mind if we wait out here?
No. Why don't we sit down?
Tom, I'm probably going to have to come out before an admission to make a phone call.
No problem.
I'm sorry. It's just there are things that are on my mind.
Well, we have seats right on the aisle, so you can just slip out.
I really enjoyed dinner. The place was very nice.
Oh. Barbara, what's the matter?
Nothing. I'm sorry. I'm not being very good company tonight.
Well, maybe I can help.
No. There's nothing anybody can do.
Is this something to do with Pennsylvania?
Why do you ask that?
Well, the trips you made before Christmas. You said a friend was ill. Does this have anything to do with that?
Tom, I really can't talk about it. You know, so often things don't turn out the way you expect them to. Plan. Everything looks like it's going right, heading in the right direction. And suddenly something goes wrong and everything has changed.
But if someone you love is ill, why can't you talk to me about it?
Tom, it's complicated. I just can't, that's all.
Are you afraid that you might hurt me?
No, no, nothing like that.
Because if that's it, you don't have to. You know, I've known for a long time that there's someone in your life that you care about more than, well, probably anybody.
Tom, it's not what you think.
Does Melinda know who it is?
No.
Annie?
No.
I thought you were pretty close to them. Barbara, if you can't talk to me about it, that's your choice. But you ought to have somebody you can talk to. It's not good to carry these feelings around alone.
I wish I could. I wish there was someone I could talk to. I'm sorry. Here you got 2 tickets to my favorite play, and all I'm doing is worrying.
You want to go in?
Well, I tell you, you know your way around the kitchen. That was a delicious dinner.
Oh, well, I'm glad I finally got you over here. God knows it wasn't easy.
Well, I feel better.
Oh, that's good. I can tell. Do you think that Melinda's, she gonna be okay?
Yes, she's gonna be okay.
You know, she told me she thought she was really gonna die in that fire.
She almost did. If Andropoulos hadn't gone in after her, in just a few more minutes. You know, sometimes an experience like that can have a lasting effect on someone's life.
What do you mean?
Coming that close to death, you know, I see it sometimes in my patients. Suddenly they realize how precious life really is. And we think we have all the time in the world. We waste so much time instead of living our lives.
Yeah, I guess I know what you mean. Oh, excuse me. Look who that is. Kim, I've
Lisa,
got to see
you. Hi.
Oh, Bob. Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt.
I know I should have called first.
Don't be silly. I'm glad
I was just leaving. I have to get back to work.
Oh, Bob, don't say that because of me.
I'm not. It's... Ask him.
No, he really did say he was going to leave easy. Early. Easy, too.
Easy early.
Just eat and run. That's Bob.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Kim, to tell you that your food is better than the food at the hospital cafeteria is to say that a rose is only slightly better than a stinging nettle.
Oh, come on. What is that supposed to be?
Well, it's your cooking. It brings out the poet in me.
I think I better put you on a diet.
Good idea.
Listen, come back soon.
Thank you. Bye, Lisa.
Oh, Bob, yes, bye. How late are you going to be working tonight?
Till about 11.
You'd better cut that out now.
Good night.
Oh, listen, I
close
really...
that door before you get a cold.
All right, doctor. Kim,
honestly, I thought he'd never leave.
Why, what's the matter?
Oh, I tell you, I've done something. I don't know whether it's right or wrong. I need to know what you think.
What is it?
Well, I made a promise to someone. You see, there's this young man, and he wants to buy the property. I guess you know that the Hughes want to sell, and Bob, they want to sell their property they have out in the country.
Well, Bob mentioned it to me.
Yes, well, all right. Brad Hollister is the young man's name, and he was very much looking forward to buying this land out there. And then he found out at the last minute that he just couldn't quite scrape together all the money he needed for the down payment. He was going to raise horses out there and everything. And after all, the Hughes were going to sell the property. And so I said, okay, I will lend him the money.
Why?
Well, because he's a friend. He is. I like him very much. I admire him. And since the Hughes wanted to sell the property anyway, and he does have all these plans for raising horses and things, I just thought, well, that I would lend him the money and help him out.
Well, Lisa, did he ask you to lend him the money?
Of course not. No, he didn't. I practically had to twist his arm to make him take it.
Yes, and you're worried about it, aren't you?
I am, and I don't know why. Do you think what I've done is foolish?
Well, honey, I don't know.
I just wanted to help a friend, that's all. And since the Hughes wanted to sell and everything, I just thought, well, I could help him. Do you think it's wrong to help a friend? It isn't, is it?
Well, I guess really it is. Well, are you going to loan him a lot of money?
Yeah, I am. It is a lot. Look, perhaps I should tell the Hughes about this and let Bob know. I should let them know that I am involved very much in this. But, well, then let's not say anything about it just yet. It's just between us, okay?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Well, we have finished our nightcaps. Mm-hmm. It's almost dawn.
You have to get up and rehearse in about a few hours.
I don't even know if it's worth going to sleep.
Ian, I command you to get some rest.
You are so beautiful, Dawn.
Nobody calls me that.
It's a beautiful name. And it suits you.
Wonderful time tonight.
Then what's wrong?
I don't know. It's just...
You're not worried about me.
Oh, no. No, of course not. It's just... I just don't know.
All right. I want you to be sure.
I just wanted to thank you.
Enjoy your dinner?
Oh, yes, very much. It was the best Greek food I've ever had. Come to think of it, it's about the only Greek food I've ever had. But I liked it very much. It was very good.
Well, I'll tell the cook you said that. She'll be very pleased.
This is really a marvelous place. I'm warning you, you're going to be seeing a lot of me.
Well, I hope I do.
There's something I wanted to ask you, Nick.
All right, what?
Well, I've been talking about you to my aunt. Kim, you met her in the hospital.
Oh, sure.
Well, she moved into a duplex several months ago, but she's been meaning to get in touch with the carpenter. She wants to get some cabinets and bookshelves done, and I was just wondering, would you be interested?
Well, now, wait a minute. You don't have to do this.
What do you mean?
If you think you have to repay me for what I did, you don't.
Nick, gosh, this isn't supposed to be a favor or anything. I could never repay you for what you've done. I just thought I'd be helping out my aunt. She does need a carpenter.
Come in.
Nikos?
Yes, what is it?
I need you out front.
What's wrong?
A big party just came in. They want the table near the dancing, and we're holding it for Mr. Pappas.
Why do you bother me with these things? It's Peter's job.
Well, I thought that maybe you could handle it better than Peter.
Now, you handle it. I'll talk to you later.
All right, Nikos. Later.
I'm sorry. They're always after me for something.
I can see that.
Now, about your aunt.
Oh, yes, she's been wanting this work done for several months now, but she just couldn't find a good carpenter.
Well, how big a job is it?
Gosh, I'm not really sure. I guess you'd have to ask her. Well, look, if you're really not interested...
Oh, of course I'm interested. It's, I just do this at night. During the day, I'm a carpenter.
Then you'll want to talk to her?
Well, let me find out what she wants. Maybe we can work something out.
Good. I'll give her the number here, and she'll get in touch with you.
Fine. Oh, I'll be seeing you at the bookstore when Mrs. Coleman starts rebuilding.
You'll be seeing me sooner than that. I really love this place.
Well, you're going to have to be my guest again.
Barbara, it was so awful today. I'm sorry. Raymond's been drinking. What's happened?
He's going crazy, Barbara. It's all the bills coming in. The rent and the car payment and the medical bills. He says he's willing to do anything to get money.
Anything? He's not violent.
No.
I just stay out of his way.
Oh, no. If he just wouldn't drink, it'd be okay, but he's just...
Claudia, you have to do something. Yeah.
Hey! Who are you talking to?
I'm sorry, I can't talk now.
Barbara?
I can't go back in there. I'm sorry.
Come on, I'll take you home.
And Linda, you know you shouldn't be running around this late at night.
I'm not running around. I just wanted to see you.
Oh, well, Bob was here earlier, and he said that you should be taking it very easy.
Really? Bob was here, Kim?
All right. Stop changing the subject. The point is, you should be home in bed.
Oh, Kim, if I did everything I had to do to keep myself well, do you know I would die of boredom? Instead of which, guess where I went?
Where did you go?
I saw Nick.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. We had such a nice talk. Gosh, he is such an intelligent man.
Ah, yes.
Well, anyway, I told him that you wanted some carpentry done, cabinets and stuff like that, and he's interested.
Oh, good.
Oh, Kim, you should see the job he did in Lisa's bookstore. You just have to ask Lisa. In fact, she wants him to work at the place when they rebuild it.
He is a master carpenter.
I see. Well, now, is this all set, or should Nick and I have a conversation?
Oh, no, of course he'll want to know what you want done, and then the cost. Oh, but Kim, please, don't let him think this is a favor.
Well, it isn't.
Good, because he won't take it if he thinks I'm trying to repay him. And how could I, anyway?
Couldn't.
I told him that you'd call, and I have the number right here, and...
All right. I promise you I will call. Thank you.
You look good. Beautiful.
You look good, too.
Come in. Sit down. Can I get you something?
No, thanks. Sorry about the way I acted at the hospital. Just that I was surprised everything kind of came back.
It's okay.
I heard about what you did. It didn't surprise me. I knew the woman you saved.
How?
I work with her at the bookstore. Oh. Not that we're friends. I just went to see her in the hospital. I'll always be very grateful to you, Nikos.
You have nothing to be grateful for. It was a bad time for you.
Yeah.
You know, I've often wondered how you were doing.
Have you?
You look different.
Yeah, well, I'm not a kid anymore.
I don't mean that.
Well, I dress a little different. Like I said, I work in a bookstore now. But that's only part-time. I have a job as a hostess in a restaurant called Copperfields.
I've heard of it.
Not like this.
Have you been okay?
Up and down.
You have friends here?
I don't know. Sometimes I think that you're the only friend I ever had.
There's a lot of good people in the world, Sheila.
Yeah. If it hadn't been for you, Well, anyway, are you going to stay in Oakdale?
For the time being. I have my job here. You know, I manage this place. Are you sorry I'm here?
No.
It does make problems, doesn't it?
Yes. I know how to keep my mouth shut.
I know that.
It's really good to see you. Really, it is. It's just that everything comes back. The place, when I came in and I heard the music and...
Look, we don't have to let anybody know that we know each other. What happened? It's all in the past. You're young, you're starting a new life. You deserve it.
You know what I thought when I saw you? I thought there was the past coming after me again.
We carry the past with us everywhere. But we don't have to let it rule our lives. We're free. We can choose our own life. You've chosen another life now, too.
I have.
Is there anyone with you tonight?
No. I'm alone. People in this town don't know anything about me.
Nothing?
Nothing. Well,
Not much. There was a guy. He was really a nice guy. But he wasn't really interested in me. He helped me when I came here. He helped me get a job. I told him a little. I said, when I was younger, I'd run away and I'd gone to Hollywood.
Hollywood? Why'd you say that?
I don't know. I guess I just thought he'd go for it. That's where most runaways head for anyway, isn't it? That's where I told him I learned how to dance.
You loved him?
I don't know. I needed him. I thought I did. I just couldn't afford to tell him the truth. You don't blame me, do you?
No. No, I don't blame you, but I am sorry. But you can't be open. There's no real friendship. There's only loneliness.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Some mornings, Nikos, I wish I could wake up and I would just know that it was all just a bad dream.
Yeah, I feel the same way, Sheila. But I found out a long time ago. I'll never be able to forget.
I'm sorry about tonight.
No. Think I care about the play? You got some bad news tonight.
I'm okay now, really.
You sure?
Yeah, Annie will be home soon. The library closes at 10.
Can't you tell me who you were talking to?
It's just an old friend.
The one you saw in the hospital?
Look, Tom, there's more to it than that. I told you before, sometimes you plan for things and things go along just fine and you can't foresee everything. Sometimes things just get out of control.
Can't something be done about it?
Maybe.
Barbara, it does have something to do with this friend who was ill, doesn't it? I want you to listen to me. And really think about what I tell you. Anything you say to me, and I think you know you can trust me, it won't go any further than the two of us. Now, if there's a legal problem, I can help. I want to help.
Tom.
Barbara, I'm worried about you. I care about you. I never stopped caring about you.
Well, you could have fooled me.
I think I care too much. I know there was something wrong between us, something I didn't understand.
There are just things, feelings that I just can't share with you.
I always wondered if there was someone else. Barbara, maybe you're not sorry things turned out the way they did, but I am. And I wish I'd been able to tell you how I felt. Then maybe you could have shared this with me.
Tom, there are other people involved.
Barbara, you won't be betraying anybody's trust if you talk to me as a lawyer and in confidence. Maybe I can help. Hey, have you heard anything I've said?
Yes.
Will you think about it?
Tom, I know you're a friend. I'm really grateful. I just have to think.
Well, sure.
No, you don't have to stay. I'm all right.
Okay.
Lisa, you are an angel. An angel. I'm gonna be rich. This land is gonna make me very rich. Woo!